On today's video, we're going to look at your running step width. We're going to talk about what it is it linked to injury, if you do have it, should you change it, and exactly how to change it. So what I'm going to do is demonstrate three sort of styles of running. Step width is more like on a spectrum. There's no set categories, but to simplify things, we can go with a wide step width, a narrow step width, and a crossover step width. So I'm going to jump on the treadmill, going to put my shorts and runners on, and then we're going to have a look at those different styles. So this is me running with a wider step width, and you can see that for the most part, when making contact with the ground, if we were to paint a line straight down the treadmill, most of my foot contact, let's just say with the right foot, is making contact to the right side of that middle line. Let's compare that to a narrow step width, where for the most part, the foot makes contact with the line. It's not to the left of it, it's not to the right of it, it's directly in the middle. And lastly, we have the crossover step width, where the right foot or the left foot will cross over that line. And so in this example, my right foot is reaching all the way across to the left side of the line and making contact. Okay, so the next question might be, how do you know what step width you have? Well, you can film yourself on a treadmill or outdoors and from behind see how you're making contact with the ground. But your shoes can also give a bit of insight as to how you're making contact with the ground. So I've got a couple of examples here. I've got my minimalist shoes that I like to wear, and you can just see, because I am a midfoot runner, you can see that most of my wear and tear is here. Now, this isn't a great example because there's not a lot of lines to tell where the wear and tear is, but you can see that most of my wear and tear is kind of in this mid portion. Now, I've actually done a lot of work on my step width because years ago, I actually had quite a crossover step width. And if you can see, most of it's in the middle, that's because when I step, it's the middle part of my shoe that's going to take most of the brunt force, and it's going to be most of the wear and tear. But I still have my shoes from a few years ago, which look extremely different. So if you can tell, most of my wear and tear is along this outer border here compared to the mid portion compared to my other shoes, because as I make contact with the ground with a crossover step width, the outer border of my shoe is going to be the first thing that makes contact with the ground and is therefore going to contribute to the most wear and tear. So the outer border of your shoe, even if you are a heel striker, the outer border is going to have significant more wear and tear if you have a crossover or narrow step width, whereas the middle portions through here will show more significant wear and tear if your step width is wider.
You can analyze your running shoes yourself, and you can comment below. Have a look at the pattern of your shoes and also compare right to left to see if there's any differences in the pattern or the severity of the wear and tear, because it can provide a lot of insights into how you're running. And I'm interested to know what you find, so comment that below. I'll also mention that when it comes to the traits of running, sometimes those who have a crossover step width, if you might not know it, sometimes you can leave like a scuff on the inside of your calf. Say if you're trail running and you've got some dirty shoes, some people tend to have mud scuffs on the inside of their calf, just because when the swinging leg doesn't have a lot of space, it can tend to brush and leave evidence of you having a crossover step width. So what about when it comes to injuries? Is it okay to have a narrow step width or a crossover step width? Is it a bad thing? Is it a bad trait? Unfortunately, there's not a lot of research to go to, but I have managed to find three papers. The first one was from Brindle and colleagues, and the title was "Changing Step Width Alters Lower Extremity Biomechanics During Running." And they had a look at a bunch of different runners and had a look at their mechanics and how they're moving. And in their discussion, they noted, "It has been reported that runners with patellofemoral pain or kneecap pain and previous ITB syndrome have approximately 3% larger peak hip adduction angles than healthy runners. Running with a wide step width decreased the peak hip adduction angle by about 3%. So essentially what they're saying is there are certain traits linked to these specific running conditions, and increasing your step width essentially removed those particular traits. The next two papers come from Stacey Mearden, and one of them looked at ITB syndrome and had a look at runners running at a narrow, preferred, and wide step width. And you can see here that the ITB strain, when eliciting different step widths, changes significantly. So you can see here, a wide step width significantly reduces ITB strain. Compare that to a narrow step width where the ITB strain is quite high. And this becomes really important because overloading your ITB could be linked to injury. The third paper, again from Stacey Mearden, was titled Effect of Step Width Manipulation on Tibial Stress During Running. And again, there was a nice graph to look at the peak shear stress on the tibia, so your shin bone, during different step widths. And you can see here that the narrow step width increases the peak shear stress on that bone significantly compared to those who run with quite a wide step width.
So when it comes down to it, it's essentially generating unnecessary forces or unnecessary strain on your body, which can potentially push those certain structures and push their capacity into injury territory. And you can see, just as a side-by-side comparison, looking at that crossover step width, it sort of creates more of a cutting action and it's less mechanical. It's moving more laterally, which, you know, is unnecessary when we're trying to move forward in the running action. So more side to side and less forward and back, and producing those forces in those directions is, like we said, unnecessary. And so these papers show the strain on the ITB, the tibia, and the patella, but I've also seen increases strain on the tib post tendon on the inside of your ankle, if you've had shin splints in the past, and also if you've had like a glute med tendinopathy or any lateral hip pain. I find that this particular trait does increase unnecessary forces on those areas as well. So if you've discovered that you do have a narrow or crossover step width, particularly if you have battled these certain injuries in the past, I've come up with a few tips to help you increase your step width. Tip number one is to increase your running cadence by 5 to 10%, particularly for those who have a cadence in those lower ranges, maybe less than 165. And simply put, if you try and take faster, quicker steps, your body struggles to find the time to cross over to have that exaggerated crossover step width, when if you tick them over quicker, the foot placement is a little bit more underneath your body. Tip number two is just to simply step wider. Try to consciously widen your step width and see what happens. And I will say that when I tell my runners to increase their step width, a lot of them exaggerate the movement and they start running side to side, and it should only be a very minor correction. Only 1 to 2 inches is probably all that's required, and videoing yourself from behind on a treadmill, getting an expert to have a look at it, can ensure that you're not over exaggerating. But even if you are running and you're trying to widen your step width, you shouldn't feel like your shoulders and head are moving side to side. It should still stay in a straight line and avoiding that side to side movement. If you like checking out videos on technique, running technique, check these videos out that I've made. And also, if you've liked or learned anything in this video, click like so I know that I'm doing a good job. It could help me make better videos in the future. And if you haven't already, you can subscribe to the channel so that you instantly get notified when a new episode comes out.